Now, as the pandemic drags on, what new trends are you seeing in terms of what workers want and what employers want?
Yeah, Emily, I think the big trend that is here to stay with us around what workers want is around flexibility. You know, whether you are a full-time employee or whether you are one of the 20 million Americans who jumped into the freelance workforce last year, it's all about working when, where, and how you want to work. And I think that's one of the reasons that freelancing in particular has taken off in such a big way. And on the company side of the house, you know, companies that I talk to are just saying, look, remote work is now part of our permanent go-forward strategy. We're figuring out how we make this a strategic asset because the war for talent has been with us for so long, and now remote work can be a competitive asset in breaking through that war for talent and reaching populations of workers that we were previously not tapping into because companies were looking in their own backyards. And that includes reaching into talent pools like the freelance economy, which has got tons of the talent that companies really need, but previously they were just not looking for because they were so used to working with kind of old and outdated ways of hiring, including, you know, on-site, on-premise, which is now, I think, proven to be, you know, very outdated as companies have figured out through the pandemic.
We've been hearing a lot about the great resignation. What's actually happening?
You know, I think this is actually a peak point that's kind of culminated as workers have looked at the work that they're doing, their value systems, the trade-offs that they were making around work and life, and are stepping back and saying, wait a minute, I want something different. I want something more. And that's causing a ton of workers to not just shift from job to job, which is certainly a lot of what's going on in the full-time employment space, but also we've done a survey recently which shows that 10 million Americans are actually considering leaving full-time work and moving into freelance. So again, I think this is a peak point from a trend that was happening pre-pandemic with, you know, employee tenures shortening, with more and more workers joining the freelance workforce. But now we're in a moment that is going to be extended with a new normal that is represented by the Great Resignation, but really looks at the workplace being much more dynamic, people moving in and out of jobs and moving into freelance at a rate we have never previously seen.
So are some companies being flooded with new talent and others losing out, or are people resigning everywhere?
You know, I think the pattern is really widespread, but where we're going to see, I think, a discrepancy is companies that really reject using remote talent as part of their strategies are going to be increasingly struggling, I think, to capitalize on where that talent is. Because what I hear is whether or not people are employees or freelance, they really want more flexibility. And that is one of the great lessons coming out of the last, you know, 18 months is people wanting those controls over when, where, and how they work. And you talk to somebody who, you know, is now being called back into the office, looking at giving up time. Maybe they were walking their kid to school or spending more time at soccer practice and really defining those boundaries differently. I think employers who don't listen to that and really are drawing firm boundaries in ways that really don't work for workers are going to be continuing to really struggle to attract talent going forward. So that's where there's going to be, I think, a challenge for employers that really don't listen to what the workers are saying they really want in terms of flexibility.
Where is demand coming from right now for freelancers in particular? And what is the supply like? What are the freelancers out there that you're seeing? What can they do? What can they provide?
So the demand is coming from really all segments of businesses. You know, we serve half of the Fortune 500. They're leaning into this trend. We are serving small businesses, mom and pop stores. They also recognize that this is a great place where they can get talent. So the demand is very widespread in the market. And on the supply side, on the talent side, you know, these are workers who have every type of skill, everything from, you know, web development, software development, design, marketing, translation, writing skills. So what we've seen over the last year plus is really a broad-based realization on both sides of the equation that so much of this work can be done as freelance and can be done by skilled professionals working remotely. So this has been an amazing moment, although I think the supply side of talent is still ahead of where businesses are because talented people have known for a long time they can and will work this way. I think it's more on the business side that people are figuring out that this can be real programmatic sustaining work for them. And that's where we're really leaning into that opportunity to educate businesses how this can work for them, how they can build really meaningful relationships on our platform with these talented individuals. It's not here today, gone tomorrow. These are sustaining ways that people can really power growth and sustainability.